Data Governance Maturity Model. What is it? In this video, let's see what it is and uncover some of its basics to guide you further. What is a Data Governance Maturity Model? First, let's start with the core, the maturity model. Maturity is a measurement of the ability of an organization for continuous improvement in a particular discipline. It's a way for an organization to assess their improvement in a particular discipline. In our case, data governance. In other words, we want to have a way where we can see where we were yesterday, where we are today, and is there any improvement or not? And where do we want to be tomorrow, and how do we get there? Most maturity models assess qualitatively and some quantitatively people culture, process structures, and objects technology. So here's the basic idea. You have a number of levels, usually from 1 to 5, though I've seen 1 to 4, 1 to 6, 0 to 5, whatever. As one increases in maturity levels and gradually adopting a new stage, or level, the rewards increase. So the overall value and impact, productivity, quality, and overall capabilities increase, while risks and waste decrease. As I mentioned, usually see 5 levels because most maturity models, including the data governance maturity models, are based on the CMM, the Capability Maturity Model, the CMM. It's an assessment model developed by the Software Engineering Institute at Carnegie Mellon University in the 1990s for the US Department of Defense in order to ascertain the process maturity levels in software development. Okay, in other words, the United States Department of Defense needed to establish criteria through which to evaluate their software contractors. I won't go into further detail, but it's important to be aware of the CMM because a lot of maturity models use this as inspiration. Because of this, you'll find quite a few similarities between them. I'll only say this, the CMM model describes the 5 levels of best engineering and management practices, which are initial, repeatable, defined, managed, and optimizing. While first applied to software development, the CMM has been developed for a range of other fields, including data governance, which is what we're talking about today. When looking specifically at data governance maturity models, there are several, and again, these are a few of them that I've addressed in more detail on LightsOnData.com, so please go check out those articles and let me know if you'd like to see any videos on them. Now, I bet you wonder, how do I choose one? Usually when you have options, you start comparing them. Are they comparable? Well, we can compare them, but they are not quite comparable, not one-to-one, and there are a lot of reasons for that. So you will need to look into some of these and see which one would suit you best. But let me give you some helpful advice. Usually these models have some similarities. For starters, each of these levels usually comes with a narrative on how your data governance program looks like, or at least part of the program looks like. Depending on the maturity model you look at, this narrative can be different. No surprise there. And it can be split into different domains. Clear as mud? Well, part of this narrative or description of the level, you might find risks and benefits associated with being at that level and recommendations on how to move up. I emphasize on might find because it all depends on the model. And for some of these, they are explicitly stated. For some, you derive them from the descriptions. And for some, it's a bit too broad and to get a concise answer. Some also come with some sort of an assessment tool so you know what level your data governance program is at, and a scoreboard to showcase your data governance program's progression to your stakeholders. Yep, data governance maturity models are not quite comparable and it can be a bit convoluted. My advice is to first consider this criteria when choosing which one to first investigate. First part of the criteria is your available budget. Yes, most cost money, some a lot of money. And the second part of the criteria, which of the models did other similar organizations to yours have adopted or created, as that can give you a good starting point into the direction that you should start focusing on. Thank you to the sponsor of this video, Dataedo. Dataedo allows you to catalog, document, and understand your data with a data dictionary, a business glossary, and ER diagrams. Go get a free trial and check them out for yourself. And guess what? Once you figure out that it's the right tool for you, you can use the following coupon code for a 10% discount on your purchase. The links are in the video's description, so start boosting your data and software initiatives today. Don't forget to check out lightsondata.com. Here you can find more informative content such as guides and templates, best practices, and other useful resources to address your questions and your challenges when it comes to data governance and data management. Please like the video if you've enjoyed it, and don't forget to subscribe to never miss out on great content. Thank you.